Petersburg, 1916. Out of nowhere, a man rose to wield a power greater and stranger than the Tsar's. And there crept through the city a whisper, ugly but persistent. Kill Rasputin.
Hurry, it's almost time. Worry. I left instructions. If it is Rasputin, he won't be shown down here till I'm alone. What about the wine?
Better powder some crystals in
yes.
glasses.
Yes, do it.
In the liquid, the strength of the poison would be diffused. On no account, drink from these five glasses. Even one glass would prove fatal.
Are you quite sure?
There's enough poison in these and the cakes to finish 20 men.
Will you wait upstairs? Mr. Oranov is there, in the little anteroom at the end of the passageway. And tell him to stop playing that gramophone. I don't want him to think that there's anyone else at home.
Your Highness.
Nicholas.
Sergei.
You're late.
I was held up at the palace. You've made the arrangements?
Yes. Oh, doctor, when I call, come down at once.
Where's the Oranov?
Upstairs.
I can't believe that tonight has really come.
How do you think it looks?
As though you had arranged it. As though everything were waiting.
Yes, well,
perhaps if I
disarrange things a little.
What did he say when you called him?
He accepted at once. He said we'd have a drink here and then go on down to the gypsies.
Pour some tea in the other cups.
Yes, yes. Don't touch these cakes.
All day I felt that it could not happen. But in some way he was bound to prevent it.
What were the rumors at the palace?
Tsarevich had another attack this morning and the accursed bleeding started again. Of course, Rasputin was called in at once.
And?
Evidently it still works, his devil's magic. He stopped the bleeding. The child fell asleep. The Empress was hysterical with relief. Everyone is waiting about to see what new powers he will acquire as a result of his latest miracle. Are you sure, quite sure, that he doesn't suspect anything? I felt suddenly on my way over here that perhaps he had engineered this meeting. And it is really we who are being led into his trap.
Nicky, you must remain calm. Only one thing is important, that we destroy this maniac before he destroys Russia.
I still can't understand why he would agree to come here of all places, and alone.
To win us over. That's obvious. We can be drawn into his camp, he'll rule the Tsar completely.
Whatever he may have done, this is still murder.
Nicky, think of the thousands of Russian soldiers who have been killed by his intrigue. Men of our own regiments. You'd better go upstairs and be absolutely quiet till I call you.
Sergei.
Yes.
Are you sure that our motives absolve us completely?
I'm not looking for absolution.
lighting the candles, huh?
Well, you gave me quite a start. Thought perhaps you weren't coming.
So, at last I enter your house, Sergei. My dear little enemy. So this is your famous palace, the Sudeikin Museum, huh? Well, I am here, it is me, the infamous Rasputin, your great and terrible enemy who has always loved you. Only today I said to the Tsar, that young Sergei is a bright one, I said, he has brains in his head. The Tsar is very fond of you, you know that, and so am I. In spite of the way you've treated me.
But I'm glad you're here. It's so difficult to meet anyone honestly at court to talk.
But you've never come to my house, and I've asked you so often. And always excuses. That beautiful cabinet. Those little drawers like a doll's house.
Yes. I understand the Tsarevich was ill again this morning.
Yes, you've heard already. He was ill, poor darling, but I mended him. So long as I am here, no harm can come to him. Remember that, Sergei.
Well, why are you so silent? Aren't you going to give me anything to drink?
Forgive me. It seems so strange seeing you here.
Yes, it is strange. And this is a strange room. Like a vault. Whom do you keep buried here? All those beautiful women whose hearts you have broken.
No, no. This is part of the wine cellar. I had it reconverted.
Ah, so that's it. And tonight we go to the gypsies, huh? Good, I'm just in the mood for it. Musical, all those wild, lovely creatures. We will sing and dance. Who has been here?
Some friends dropped by.
And I suppose they scuttled away when they heard I was coming.
Here, let us drink to our first meeting in my house. Why do you look at me like that?
I don't know. This wine.
Not a bad vintage. Chateau Isser, 1908.
We shall drink to our newfound friendship in good Russian wine, honest wine. With no foreign intrigues in it.
You talk as though I were trying to poison you.
Are you? I have need of you, Sergei. I can do great things for you. I need men like you to work with me. Men with brains. Not those laced-up mummies at court. Good. Good wine! Now we go to the gypsies. You must bring your balalaika with you. I hear you play like an angel. You must play for me. Come here, Sergei. I can't see you. Closer. Closer. Sit here on this stool. Let me see what you really are. You've been hiding from.
What are you doing?
Our destinies are very close. I've always known it. I will be with you until the hour of your death.
How do you say that?
Sometimes the living and the dead are bound together. Oh, I have had many warnings. The other day when I crossed the river, I had a vision. I saw the great square filled with bodies. Many of the great ones were amongst them. And the river had turned blood red. Did I frighten you?
No, no, no. Tonight we must laugh and make music, because we are no longer enemies. And it is the law that men must love one another. More wine, Sergei. Do me a favor before we go. Play me one song. You know my favorite. Our cakes!
I'm hungry.
Ah, so Russian. You must not hate me anymore. You must love me as they do at the palace, the little Tsarevich and his father and mother, huh? Good. Now, one song. One song before we go. You know what that song reminds me of? When I was a boy, I used to wander along the shore of our village hunting for seagulls. And it was there, one autumn evening when the birds were flying low over the fields, I had my first vision, and I knew that somehow I must get to St. Petersburg, that I, a simple peasant lad, had been chosen to save Russia. And I went. I did as I was bidden. With my great muddy boots, I walked past the guards and flunkies into the rooms of our little father, the Tsar. And I told him the truth. I alone have told him the truth. Only I. Don't stop, Sergei. That is so beautiful. Hear me. You are an officer, an aristocrat, and you hate me, but you...
What is it? What's the matter?
My throat. It's so dry. More wine, Sergei! More wine! More wine!
How long's he been in there?
Almost an hour. How soon does the poison take effect?
Almost at once. Must have drunk something by now.
The music stopped again. It's over. He's dead.
Wait, Sergei said he would call us. But he must be dead by now.
Sergei, it's done. Sergei!
He's alive. The poison has had no effect.
That's impossible. There's enough poison in one of those cakes alone.
I tell you, he's eaten five of those cakes and drunk four glasses of wine. You're right, Mickey. He's a devil incarnate.
And he knows. He knows why I asked him here.
What are you going to do?
I can't stand his raving any longer. Uranov, give me your gun.
No, no, you can't. It's got to be finished. If you shoot him, there'll be traces, blood.
What difference does that make now? Quickly.
Sergei, listen to me. You know what he prophesied.
Yes, I know. It's got to be done. Whatever happens, 20 of us.
Sergei, listen to me, I beg of you.
The poison must take effect. It may be that on such...
Let him go, Serge. This was madness from the beginning.
I'm coming.
Great and terrible things, Sergei. I was right. This room is a vault. And within its walls... Oh, Sergei, this wine is heavy. Why did you make me drunk before we go to the gypsy? Why have you brought me here? I know what you were planning. I came to show you that I am the stronger. I'm always the stronger. I have on my side all the powers of heaven. I walk on the wings of the wind. Oh, Sergei, give me your arm. I am a little gypsy. We go to the gypsies, the wild, lovely. Wait, Sergei. We have forgotten something. Don't try to kill me, Sergei. You have a gun in your pocket. But if I die, within 1 year, the reign of the Romanovs will end. And the Black Night will engulf all Russia. This is what she tells me. You fool! Why do you want to kill me? Can't you see? Without me, the whole pack of cards will crumble. Give me the gun, Sergei. Give me the gun. I command you. Give me the gun.
He's dead.
Quickly, we must get him to the river.
We must get the car. Someone say with Sergei.
Help me. We must get rid of these stains. Boom over there.
You burned this?
In the furnace.
We must get some rags and water.
Thank you.
Such was the death of Rasputin. Within a year from that night, the reign of the Romanovs came to an end. The prophecy of Rasputin had been fulfilled.
Tuesday Night Chills, Danger on the CBS Television Network.